focus on the story of Maharashtra. Its national impact. Let's quickly pull up those graphics on your screen right now. What is the possible national impact? Could it influence the voter opinion in Jharkhand and Delhi? Remember, if this model is successful, and in the immediate future, if it is successful, then there are two state elections coming up. One in Jharkhand, and then later in 2020, early 2020, the state of Delhi. Could it influence voter opinion in both these states? Could it give opposition some teeth in parliament? At this moment, the index of opposition unity is a little low because of the massive mandate or the massive size of the treasury benches in parliament. Could it help perhaps reverse this trend or give more teeth to the index of opposition unity? Could it force a rethink among the Bihar alliance partners? And there is a reason why I say this. You've got a Mr. Nitish Kumar who uses communalism or the communal tag for the BJP quite frequently when it does not work for him. He's done that since 2005. Will he do that again? Will it give him that opportunity? The BJP may have to strike an accommodating note with its two big allies. One is the Janata Dal United and the other is the Shiromani Akali Dal. The JDU in Bihar and the Shiromani Akali Dal in Punjab. Remember, their most consistent ally and the biggest one, the Shiv Sena, is now not with them. So there are these only two big NDA partners who are left. Will they strike an accommodating move? It's a test for the Congress acceptability among the Muslim vote bank. Remember, a huge thing, the national impact. In the states of Jharkhand, Delhi, then the state of Bihar, other state elections also, and the different local body elections also. When Congress goes to polls, will this new ideological experiment of Maharashtra weigh in on the minds of the Muslim voters who are considered to be a vote bank in some cases of the Congress party? If the vote is favorable for the Congress, will these ideological lines in other states also blur, just like they have blurred, whether for power or not, have they or will they blur in other states as well? These are the possible scenarios as far as the national impact to this new Mahavikas Aghadi is concerned. Let me first introduce my guest this evening, my first guest, Pawan Kheda of the Congress Party. Mr. Kheda, good evening. We were on the Hindi broadcast just good a short evening. While ago. Now switching over to English, want to know from you what you think about this assessment, about the national impact. Clearly, I'm sure you also realize the burden of expectations.
Well, this is a responsibility which three of us have come together to shoulder. And it is a new experiment, undoubtedly. I think adherence to constitutional norms will take the center stage because of the common minimum program. We have a framework within which we have to operate. Three of us realize that. Therefore, any point of difference, all those differences that you just mentioned, I don't think they will come in the way of delivering good governance because of a particular framework that we put in place even before we announced our alliance. Unlike neighboring Haryana, where JJP and BJP came together, we are yet to see a CMP. The cabinet got formed 22 days after the results were announced. So that's the difference. That's where lies the difference. And yes, the entire country now will be watching, hopes that this succeeds, and we focus on governance, on the day-to-day issues that affect people's lives every day. These are the issues that need to be focused upon when you are in power, when you are in government. You can talk about your slogans, your ideology. Your ideology cannot go out of the framework of the Constitution of India. So I don't see any dichotomy there. I don't see any contradiction there at all.
Kheda, the reason why I ask you this question is I hope you realize, and as a political party, which took its own sweet time, by the way, to take this decision, this ideological decision, is also very, very cautious trudging on this path. For instance, the senior leadership of the Congress was not there to be seen, in sharp contrast to what we saw as far as Karnataka is concerned when the JDS chief minister was being sworn in. entire opposition, I mean, great index of opposition unity is shown on stage. Look what happened to that alliance. Are you very cautious?
I wouldn't read too much into these small issues. You said that we took a lot of time, our own sweet time, and I'm glad we did that. After all, you just come together to form a government? But that's the BJP for you. Overnight, wake up the president, wake up the governor, put the constitution to sleep, and just immediately cobble a government. That's not what we want to do. That's not what we ever wanted to do. That's why we took our time to create a common minimum program. Mm. I insist on this. The importance of manifestos, the importance of common minimum programs it has to be underlined, it has to be repeated, reiterated, so that everybody understands that we mean business, we mean governance, we really mean it. We don't want to just waste these 5 years doing nothing and fighting and, you know, just countering the divisive agenda of the BJP. No, we have our own agenda, which is the development agenda. And that's a stronger agenda. We've always, Congress, after all, has been, they keep accusing us, 70 saal, 70 saal, toh 70 saal mein kuch kaam kiya, isliye baar baar jitaya hume. That's what Congress is known for, and we want to be known for that.
Okay. All right. Thank you very much, Mr. Pawan Kheda, spokesperson of the Congress, for joining us and answering these questions. Because, you know, I feel that whatever has had to happen in Maharashtra, at least in terms of government formation, has happened. Of course, there'll be a couple of other surprises, if at all. But its national impact is what we should be talking about and thinking about. Thank you so much for commenting on that. So, Deendra Kulkarni, you're an author and a columnist, is also now with us. Mr. Kulkarni, welcome. Let me give you your time, your assessment on specifically this point, because I feel that this is what is going to be of great interest from here on. An experiment is in progress. Its success or failure will also determine whether ideology means anything or not in this country. Where do you stand on this issue?
This is a major experiment that has begun in Indian politics, and it is going to have far-reaching impact. First of all, the ideological component of the impact. This coming together of the Shiv Sena, the Congress, and the Nationalist Congress Party to form a coalition government connotes victory for two important constitutional ideals and principles. One is secularism, the other is democracy. The very first sentence of the common minimum program of this coalition says that the alliance partners are committed to uphold the constitution, the values of secularism enshrined in the Indian constitution. This says a lot, because all of us know that the Shiv Sena comes from a different ideological background, but it has taken a big turn to partner with the Congress and the NCP, and thereby signifying a major split in the Hindutva ideology. Hmm. The BJP, for example, has all the time shown its aversion towards secularism. The Prime Minister of India has never uttered the word secularism, even though it is part of the preamble of the constitution, because they have aversion for secularism. Now, here is a party which was until recently with the BJP, which also swore by Hindutva, has now committed itself to upholding secular values of the constitution. So therefore, this is a big victory for secularism in India. It just goes to show that any party that rejects secularism, India will reject that party. The same thing is going to happen to the BJP if it continues to discard the secular values or to belittle the secular values of the constitution. The second victory, ideological victory, is for democracy. See, had this midnight coup that took place a few days ago in Mumbai, Raj Bhavan, had it not happened, and had just the Shiv Sena, Congress, NCP come together to stake the claim and also prove their majority, democracy would not have been such a big issue. In fact, many would have accused the Shiv Sena of political opportunism. But what happened a few days ago in Raj Bhavan, with the connivance of the Rashtrapati Bhavan, the manner in which the mandate was sought to be stolen.
Sure.
Now, that has made this issue into a struggle for democracy.
Okay.
And therefore, the coming together of these parties is also a big victory for democracy
in
India.
Maybe within a few days or months will be forgotten. And that's not a commentary on how we do our politics and how people have a very short memory. But then, this, I'm sure this alliance will be remembered for what it does rather than what was done in the past, right? Niranjan Shetty is with us. We also have Vikram Singh, the leader of the Shiv Sena. Pawan Dahat, you're a journalist with Huffington Post India. And I have Samir Dalwai, NCP spokesperson, with me. Good to have all of you. Mr. Dalwai, let me ask you this question first. I hope you realize the burden of expectations. You know, I asked this question of the Congress also. The burden of expectations in the state of Maharashtra, more than the Congress party, it rests on your shoulders. I would say not even the Shiv Sena. It rests on the shoulders of the man who was the architect of this alliance, Mr. Sharad Pawar. Do you think he realizes the importance of its success?
Absolutely, and what a brilliant question that is, because it's not just the responsibility, it's also the accountability towards the people of Maharashtra, because we are inheriting a state which has been left in a big financial doldrums. And we need to rebuild that, and we need to take Maharashtra back to its original glory. And the challenges are humongous, and I agree with you, it rests largely on the broad, sturdy shoulders of Mr. Sharad Pawarji to be able to guide all the partners together. It's not just three major parties, but also a few more smaller parties. Fortunately, there's a very good sense of understanding and a sense of the crisis that the state finds itself in. And we all need to buckle up, we need to put our hands together, we need to hit the ground running, and we need to understand that we owe it to the people of Maharashtra. We've given them a government after almost more than a month, and we owe it to them. And like somebody rightly mentioned, what's happened is gone. What we need to know is, if we serve the people of Maharashtra well, only then will they support us. And that will be the true hallmark, or the true way we can judge this alliance. So okay. I'm very happy. I offer my congratulations to all the parties who formed this government. But I also would like to say that we need the support of not just all the people of Maharashtra, but also the BJP, because we very strongly believe in these democratic values, and the BJP is a very large party in the parliament, in the assembly as well, and we will look forward to their constructive opposition. We don't want to have any politics of revenge, because that is fine between the political parties, but at the cost of playing revenge with each other, you're ignoring the state of Maharashtra, and that's Shetty, very, very important. Going
Niranjan Shetty, Mr. Dalwai right now is talking exactly how the Prime Minister speaks when there is a new parliament session, right? Where he says that I look forward to a constructive session, constructive discussion on the floor of the House where the opposition is going to participate, and then we all know what happens, right? And now I want to ask you this question. Will you listen to the advice of the Prime Minister and be a constructive opposition?
See, basically you need to understand, Sanket, I thank Samir that in his opening remark he mentioned about, you know, certain things that he knew that the state, when we too inherited what was in a financial doldrums, in spite of that, you know how for 5 years the Devendra Fadnis took the reins from the previous government. It was Prithviraj Chauhan, and thereon we faced with the drought situation for almost 5 years continuously, and then how he, you know, did lot of works under the Jalyukta Shivar, or probably along with the center's assistance, like, you know, giving the loans to the farmers, or probably waiving of their loans, or, you know, constructing the proper infrastructure which was languishing for almost more than 30 years, which Mr. Pawan Kera spoke about. For, you know, you are speaking about development as a plank, you know, as a common minimum program. I thank them that today, now at least development is on their agenda after BJP took the reins from there, and then development was on the main plank of us.
Let
so
me
I
let
would
me now
appreciate. I will.
Mr. Shetty, are you scared of this?
I am saying.
Are you scared of this alliance?
No, I will.
Do you think that if they are successful,
nothing,
they will rob you of this whole ideological discourse, which the BJP, by the way, is propagating even now. Even now. Reminding that the Shiv Sena had a communal past.
See, I would only cite one example, but let the panelists not judge me based on the statement that I make as neither as an astrologer or as a superstitious person. But then I am seeing Rahu, Ketu and Shani coming together. So you know what happens when Rahu, Ketu and Shani comes together. Basically, when itself it says in Hindi, jiska aram mein hant dikhta ho, to basically normally no astrologer speaks such kind of truth, but I think we can see what is the future lies in it. But having said that, I can only assure Mr. Sameer that whatever the development work we left behind, if they continue to take it ahead, of course they will find
well, they will not.
A,
they've already spoken about scrapping the bullet train.
Supportive opposition.
They've already spoken about saving RA. So those are two projects for you.
Sarkit, I'd just like to add that let me assure all our viewers that we will depend on much more than just astrology to run this straight and give them a good government as they deserve, rather than just depending on astrology.
Okay. Pawan, larger question. If, and this is a huge if this works, then should this or will this become a sort of a template or a model to be replicated elsewhere in this country, that the discourse around ideology is a thing of the past? And if you just concentrate on development, then things work out. After all, in 2014, the vote or the mandate to Prime Minister Modi was for development.
Uddhav Thackeray's grandfather, Prabodhankar Thackeray, was a great proponent of Bahujan Hindutva. And that does not go very likely with the BJP. So that's Hindutva, that Bahujan centric Hindutva brings Shiv Sena somewhere closer to NCP, which is a Maratha centric party. So these are not really a realignments of, I mean, this is not a realignment of different or extremely divergent ideologies. And whatever that we saw happen in Maharashtra on last Saturday, somewhere that entire scene has ended up giving legitimacy to Uddhav Thackeray's government. So I don't see an immediate threat to this government.
Okay, that's very significant. Vikram Singh hamare saath jud gaye hain. Vikram Singh, main aapse ye puchna chahta hu ki ye jo zahir si baat hai, ummeed khub sari hai is alliance se, is aghadi se. Aapko lagta hai ki ek samanvay ban payega? Common minimum program, jo nyuntam saajha karyakram hai, wo to aapne bana liya hai. लेकिन एक जो कोऑर्डिनेशन होता है आप में और एनसीपी के बीच में, एनसीपी और कांग्रेस के बीच में, यहां दो ही पार्टियों में खिटपिट होती है, आप तो तीन हैं.
देखिए, आज महाराष्ट्र की जो समस्याएं हैं उसको कांग्रेस को भी पता है, एनसीपी को भी पता है और शिवसेना को भी, और जो लोगों को जो उम्मीदें हैं और उसी को देख हुए ये एक मिनिमम प्रोग्राम बना है. और उसमें यही है कि महाराष्ट्र के विकास पे ध्यान दिया जाएगा. महाराष्ट्र की जो समस्याएं हैं, किसानों की हैं, पानी की हैं या और जो सूखे की हैं, ये सारी चीज़ों के ऊपर काम होना है. इसमें भले ही सबकी विचारधारा अपनी अपनी हो, लेकिन उन विचारधाराओं को अलग रख के अभी सिर्फ और सिर्फ काम पर ध्यान दिया जाएगा, महाराष्ट्र के विकास पर ध्यान दिया जाएगा. तो मैं समझता हूँ कि उसमें ये गठबंधन चलेगा, क्योंकि उसमें कोई किसी तरीके का किसी को कोई दिक्कत नहीं होगी और पब्लिक के लिए अच्छा काम होगा और महाराष्ट्र की जनता भी इससे खुश होगी और ये पांच साल तक ये गवर्नमेंट चलेगी.
ओके ओके. सुदीन कुलकर्णी, लेट मी कम बैक टू यू. यू नो, वन सिग्निफिकेंट क्वेश्चन ओवर हियर इज, एंड वी वर स्पीकिंग टू अ लॉट ऑफ एनालिस्ट, एंड आई वुड वांट यू टू वे इन ऑल्सो एंड यू टू गिव मी योर ओपिनियन. द बिगेस्ट टेस्ट nationally will be acceptability among the Muslim vote bank or the perceived vote bank of the Congress party, whether they will be able to accept this alliance. Will the Muslims be pragmatic enough to say that, hey, this is an alliance limited to Maharashtra? the Congress for us remains the same. And that will be intact. Because that's going to be a big win for the Congress.
We should not interpret secularism as secularism for Muslims, secularism for Hindus or for any other religious community. Secularism is for all. Secularism is a basic principle that unites India. And therefore, the most heartening thing about the three parties coming together is that one party, which had an anti-secular image because of its past philosophy as well as practice, has now come together and given a firm commitment to abide by the secular principles of the Constitution. Now, this is a big change on the part of the Shiv Sena. As one of the panelists said, that the Shiv Sena's history itself shows, not going back to the grandfather of Uddhav Thackeray, Prabodhankar Thackeray, it has evolved in a very different fashion and it is continued to evolve. Just this morning, I heard Aditya Thackeray saying that secularism is nothing but Maharashtra Dharma. Maharashtra Dharma is inclusive. It does not discriminate. Now, if this is what the Shiv Sena has come to, it should be welcome not only by the people of Maharashtra, but also by the people of other states.
Mr. Kulkarni,
and therefore, my appeal to the Congress party is, you know, there should be no appeasement of any community. All should be treated equally with justice, without any discrimination, and this is
no. My point is acceptability among traditional voters, acceptability in the Shiv Sena of this alliance, acceptability in the Congress voters as far as this alliance is concerned nationally, acceptability in the NCP, which I don't think is a huge problem because you've got a Sharad Pawar. Do you think acceptability nationally is going to be a crucial next challenge? Because that shapes a new form of politics.
There is a challenge, and the responsibility rests on the Shiv Sena. Mm. The Shiv Sena has to change both its articulation as well as its policies and performance in government and outside government, and show itself to be a truly patriotic nationalist party that makes Vikram no distinction Singh. On the basis of religion.
Vikram Singh, aapse kuch din pehle ek Shiv Sena ke pravakta aaye the yahan par is manch pe, unhone ye bola ki, और मैं बार बार ये दोहराता हूँ बिकॉज आई फील दैट दिस इज अ वेरी डिलिशियस आर्ग्यूमेंट एंड आई कांट लेट गो ऑफ इट बिकॉज इट स्टक इन माय माइंड. विक्रम सिंह जी, शिवसेना के एक प्रवक्ता ने ये बोला कि दरअसल सेक्युलरिज्म और हिंदुत्व, धर्मनिरपेक्षता और हिंदुत्व दरअसल एक ही चीज़ है. और मैंने उनसे ये पूछा, अगर एक ही चीज़ है तो फिर अब तक लड़ क्यों रहे थे, फिर लड़ाई किस बात की थी शिवसेना में?
देखिए जी, उन्होंने किस संदर्भ में कहा ये तो मैं नहीं कह सकता, मैंने सुना भी नहीं उनका बयान. लेकिन अगर देखा जाए, अगर आज हम ये सोचें कि बीजेपी हिंदुत्व के लिए काम करती है, तो मुझे ये भी नहीं लग रहा कि बीजेपी को अगर हम ये कहें कि हिंदुत्व के लिए काम कर रही है, क्योंकि वो हमेशा 135 करोड़ की बात करते हैं, या कभी आपको ऐसा लग रहा हो कि सिर्फ हिंदुओं के लिए काम करते हैं. तो काम जब सबके लिए कर रहे हैं, सब उनकी उनके उसमें ये है, तो फिर उसको हम सेकुलरिज्म, एक तरह से सेकुलरिज्म ही कहेंगे उसको. और आज तक बीजेपी ने हिंदुओं के लिए मुझे नहीं लग रहा कुछ कोई काम किया है. तो ये सब चीजें कई बार जो है, बीजेपी अपने दोनों तरफ से दोनों हाथों में लड्डू रख रही है. कुछ लोग उनको हिंदुत्व के साथ जोड़ते हैं, जो कुछ लोग उनको जो समझने वाले वो ये भी सोचते हैं कि भाई 135 करोड़ की बात करते हैं और ऐसा नहीं है कि दूसरे लोगों के लिए वो कुछ नहीं कर रहे. तो ये चीज कहीं ना ये चीज कंफ्यूजन पैदा करती है कि इनको सेकुलर पार्टी बोले या हिंदुत्व की पार्टी बोले.
लेट्स जस्ट होप दैट दिस न्यू एक्सपेरिमेंट पेव्स वे फॉर अ न्यू फॉर्म ऑफ पॉलिटिक्स इन दिस कंट्री. वी हैव सीन सोशल इंजीनियरिंग, बट दिस इज आइडियोलॉजिकल इंजीनियरिंग इन दिस कंट्री. हाउ सक्सेसफुल इज इट गोइंग टू बी इन द फ्यूचर, वी विल होपफुली नॉट हैव टू वेट वेरी लॉन्ग, बिकॉज इन इंडियाज पॉलिटिक्स इलेक्शंस आर अ ग्रेट वे टू मेजर व्हाट इज सक्सेसफुल एंड व्हाट इज नॉट, एंड यू हैव गॉट elections all the time in this country. Thank you so much.